Hello, my name is Daniel Bazin, and I'm a senior physicist here at the NSCL on the campus of Michigan State University. Part of my responsibilities is to assist experimenters with using large detectors such as the one I'm presenting here today. The piece of equipment which is behind me is called the SA100 spectrograph. It is the largest detector that we have here at the lab, and also the one which is the most often used. This detector allows us to study the nature and the structure of nuclei, in particular of the very rare isotopes that we produce here at the NSCL. So the rare isotopes which are produced in those reactions can be then characterized by this very large detector. They are conducted and they go up to what we call the focal plane, where a set of detectors can characterize their positions, angles, and energies. And from this data, we can not only know which nucleus was produced in the reaction, but we can also measure their very characteristics. So in brief, this device is at the same time a collector, because it collects the nuclei, a filter, as well as an analyzer, because it also measures the characteristics of the particles. So by tracking the position, the speed, and angles of the particle, the SA100 can help to study strange modes of vibrations or the exchange of protons and neutrons between the reactor nucleus and the target during the collision. Usually this type of device is horizontal, but this one is particular because it's mounted vertically, and mostly for footprint reasons. It takes much less floor space to have a vertical device than a horizontal device. It is very large and weighs in at 300 tons. This device can rotate around the pivot where the target is located, and it rotates on the very big steel track. Of course, it goes very slowly. This machine, although it looks very big, it is three stories tall, is actually very accurate given its size, because it can measure the speed of the particles down to 0.01%. So if you were to measure the speed of a car with this device, you could measure, which was running by about 50 miles an hour, you could measure it down to 0.04 miles per hour. Of course, the particles that we measure here are much faster. They go to about one-third of the speed of light, which corresponds to 200 million miles per hour.